Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. I'm Chris and this is my lovely wife Jo. This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it.
Amen.
Today we are diving into a recipe that's a great game changer to all the busy bees out there. Isn't it, Jo?
Absolutely. If you are coming back home after a long day's work or if you are in need of a quick and satisfying meal for your family, they have got you covered. This is a recipe that's rich in flavor and super easy to make. It's chicken masala gravy. Without wasting much time, come, let's get started.
Oh wow.
For a simple and easy chicken masala gravy, I'm going to make a special homemade masala. So I put the stove on, let the pan get hot. Here I've got a tablespoon of coriander seeds. I'm adding that. Then half a teaspoon of cumin, half a teaspoon of fennel, then this is half a teaspoon of peppercorns, about 20 peppercorns are there. Then here I've got 3 cardamoms, a few small sticks of cinnamon and 3 cloves. So we'll add that. And here I've got about 8 cashew nuts. If you don't have cashew nuts, you can add almonds or any other nut. Maybe you can add even if you don't have almonds or cashew nut or you can add the grams also. The grams, the roasted grams that we eat. So you can add that. That is, in Hindi we call it dalia.
Or channa.
Channa.
Channa is with the skin. This dalia is without
the skin. Without the skin only I'm saying. We need the one. So you can add that, about 1 tablespoon of that channa. If you don't have cashew nuts or almonds. Watch our video till the end so that you don't miss out on anything. So we roast this till you get a nice aroma. Here I got a sprig of curry leaves. I just removed the leaves, the curry leaves. I'm getting a nice aroma from all this. Let the curry leaves, you know, it should become dry in this. Just a few curry leaves, just one sprig. Okay, I can get the nice roasted smell. I'm going to turn off the stove. Once it's cool, I'll grind mixer blender to a nice powder. So now I'm going to put the stove on. Let's pour some oil, about 2 tablespoons. And I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of ghee. This is optional. If you don't want to use ghee, you can add extra oil instead of ghee. So let it get hot. Okay. Here I've got 7 onions, finely chopped. I'll just add this. The oil is hot, so let's add this. Onion is the main ingredient in this, and we are not adding any tomato and all that. Let's try this. Do you ever come home from work and wish you could whip up a delicious meal without any hassle? We have all been there. So that's why I made this recipe, this dish. It's very easy for people who go to work. See, I use chopper. This we bought it online and it's very easy when I... This chopper is just the right one for me. I've used so many other choppers, but somehow I find that they don't chop so finely. But this one has been so good and so faithful to me. So it has got a thread or string. So it can break sometimes, but mine has lasted for very long. So this is a brand new one which I have not used. I've used the old one, but I'm showing you the brand new one. So this, we always keep one handy at home, just in case if anything happens to the old one. So I'm showing the new one. This is a nice chopper and you get it online. So that's why it's very good for people like working women and some men who are working and who do the cooking at home. Choppers are very handy for that. Okay, I'll add some salt to this because salt will speed up the frying. So I've added a teaspoon of salt. We'll allow it to become slightly golden in color. Okay, the onions are frying nicely. The stove is on high flame only. So the raw smell has gone and it has changed color nicely. Almost it's going to get brown. I'm adding 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste. 1 heaped tablespoon of ginger garlic paste. Let's fry this till the raw smell disappears. The raw smell of ginger garlic is gone and I'll add the chicken. You can cut the chicken into small pieces if you don't like big pieces.
Did you tell how much chicken?
This is 1 kg chicken. Okay, I'll just wash my hands. Now we'll fry this. Now I think I'll increase the flame. I want the chicken to be seared actually. See, our chicken is seared. The flame was on high only all this while. And we'll add the spices. Here I've got about half a teaspoon of turmeric powder. Here I've got half a teaspoon of spicy chili powder. And 1 teaspoon of Kashmiri chili powder. This is for color. It hardly has any spice in it. Let's mix all the spices together till they are all nicely coated to the chicken. All the masalas are well combined. Now I'll add. Here I've got 3 green chilies cut lengthwise into halves. It depends on how spicy you like. You can add or you can reduce the spiciness. This is a very simple gravy but very delicious. Let's add the homemade powder that we just made. So yeah. And mix it well.
Wow, the aroma is so rich.
Because these are fresh spices. So that's why. Let's add some water. About 3/4 cup of water I think I would have added. I've added water so that whatever is stuck to the pan, the caramelized portions will come out when we add the water, because that is the one that makes it delicious. Because they are fried nicely, so it gives a nice taste. Yeah. So if you want more gravy, you can add water at this time. If you want it like a curry or something, if you want it more liquidy like a curry, then you can add more water. I think I'll add some more water. This will go well with chapatis and rotis and rice.
Is it 1 cup of water now?
It's almost 1 cup now I've added. Totally 1 cup of water I've added, more or less. I had increased the flame in between, so now I'm going to reduce it and cover and cook till the chicken is done. Let the chicken cook for 15 minutes. 15 minutes have passed. Now let's see our chicken. Wow, the oil has come on top. The chicken has come away from the bone, so it's nicely cooked. Wow, it smells so delicious. Now, we'll turn off the flame. Squeeze some lime juice. I got half a lime. I'll just squeeze that. And we'll garnish with freshly chopped green coriander. That's it. And now it's time to taste. Now is the best part.
Yeah.
Let's give it a taste. Okay, let's taste this.
The chicken is so tender and the flavor is an explosion with every bite. You did it, Joe. It's too good. I'll just take some onions also.
And that homemade masala gives it such a unique depth.
Yeah,
it does. I must try this. It's a must try recipe. It's so quick, super easy to make. Anyone
Guys,
can do this.
I'm tasting this for y'all. And I'm telling you, it's too good.
And don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel. And we love all the comments that you have been giving us. So beautiful. We enjoy reading all of them.
This is Chris and Joe signing off.
Thanks for watching. God bless you all.
And don't forget that God loves you all.
Happy cooking. Huh? Very nice. All that, no?